Hello and welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host of Toy Therapist, aka Matthew Grant, and today, as you can see, I'm looking at another Star Wars Black Series figure. No other figure. This is one of the first vehicles that they released in this particular line, and I was very excited that they did do it. I've missed out on this in the original vintage and the re-release lines. I've always missed out on it. I love this particular speeder bike. It just has so many memories for me. So I really am happy that I can do this particular review. They've done one with the Biker Scout, the Shadow Biker Scout, which I've missed out on that as well. And now I kind of missed out on the one from The Mandalorian with Baby Yoda, which is a bit of a shame. But I'm happy that I at least got one of them. I do want to get myself another Biker Scout just to have two, but just have the figure from the archive line, so which I'm going to try and get my hands on one. But anyway, let's go around the box. As you can see, it's a Biker Scout, and this is one of the first vehicles that they ever did release. And there's no blurb on the back as such, but you are getting a really nice picture from Return of the Jedi there as well of the Biker Scout. Absolutely love the costume, love the speeder bike, love everything about it. So anyway, let's get to the actual figure. As you can see, the Biker Scout is outside the packaging, and it's just amazing. Love this particular figure. This is one of my top favorite troopers. Okay, it's just they look so cool. They didn't have full armor. They were just literally racing through the planets of Endor. That's the first time you get a chance to see them, and they are pretty cool as well. But before I do anything else, let me get to the figure, and I'll go through to the bike itself. So the actual figure, okay, does have a good range of movements. Okay, nice head movements as well. And as well, you got the old arm joints. You get a bit of a swivel in the old bicep. Nothing in the elbow. You get a little bit of play there, but not too much. And you're getting a little bit of a little vice swivel, but it's not much. It's a bit stiff, but it is there. You're getting a bit of a swivel all there on the old shin, and you're getting the old knee joint as well. You're getting a pistol, and I put that into his holster as well. Good range of movement. Very, very happy with that. Love the sculpt, love the finish, love everything about it. It is a nice figure put together. I am going to get myself one from the archive line, so I got one that is a bit more updated. My visor is a bit droopy. I'm not sure why that is. I think it's a bad mold. I think the head sculpt is a bit of a letdown with that. But the detailing on the front is on point. I mean, come on, it's just when there's a trooper, it is perfect. They normally do them quite well. But mine is that there. It's a bit of a letdown for me. I didn't even know that because it's the first time I'm taking the box. I've had this now for the best part of about 2 to 3 years, and now I'm a chance to take him out. This is the first time I've taken him out of the packaging. And I do like the figure, even though it's got his flaw. Love the finish there on the boots. Nice little bit of mudding there. Nice bit of a weathering effect. Really lovely. But I am going to get myself an updated version from the archive line. I did say as well that this is their first vehicle, which is correct. Now they have done as well. So this has had like, this is the first. They had this shadow. They had the Endor set. And as well, they done the Mandalorian. So he's had about four speeders, basically. We've had about four, which is fine. I do want to get the one from the Mandalorian because it is white. Wouldn't mind getting the shadow one because it's all black. If I can, I'm not all that bothered if I can't, but I will get them at some point. The only bit of a letdown really for me is this. This is a bit too high, so if you want to have it standing next to it, it doesn't quite work. But if you're having it riding it in a really good sort of resort dramatic poses, you can, because that ball joint is really quite nice. It's nice and sturdy, and you can easily just pop it off and pop it on quite easily. Really nice. You're getting the old blaster there as well that does turn. I remember the original ones. The original ones used to basically you used to press a button and they used to just disassemble, like look like it's been blown up. This doesn't have that gimmick, which is quite a shame, but the other one was quite a pain to put it back because you can easily lose pieces quite easily. So finish wise and plastic is absolutely lovely. Love the dials there, love the scuffing there. It is a really nice vehicle, a really, really lovely vehicle. I just wish this was a little bit short, just a tiny bit. But it is really on point. I just didn't think it was that big. I really didn't think it was that big. So you can easily get him on. So he says, so you can get him on. You clip the feet, you put the feet through in here. And they are little stoppers there as well that you can put his... So you've got little stoppers there, little hole, little pegs. So you can put that in on there and... Right, get this on properly. It is a bit of a job to do. Especially when you've got your camera in front of you, and it's a bit difficult. Right, get that in there. That's not in there properly, but I will get it in there. I will find a way to get him in there properly. I will get him in there properly, but... So that will do for the moment. I will get him on there properly and get him all posing, but... For the first venture with the vehicles, I really think, oh god, there's quite a lot of fireworks going off at the moment. Bonfire Night has finished, but people are still letting them off, which is quite annoying. but as a first vehicle, the first attempt at a vehicle, they've done a very good job. They've done as well Luke's Land Speeder, they've done a Drew back, I think that was the second one that they'd done. Then they did Ray's Speeder Bike and Luke's Land Speeder as well. And they've done as well a snow speeder. So they've done quite a few speeders. They haven't done any sort of... Oh yeah, and I forgot, they've done the First Order TIE Fighter as well. So I'm hoping at the moment they will do Slave 1. That'll be the one ship that I would want to get. And I wouldn't want to miss out on that one more than anything else. You can still get the snow speeder quite easily. I don't know what I will do, but if they do an X-Wing, I will get myself an X-Wing. But the only problem is, though, I haven't got the space to put them up at the moment, which is quite a shame. They may do a Millennium Falcon, but I can see that being expensive, because if you think about it really as well, these are like 7-inch figures, so that will be expensive. Millennium Falcon would be lovely, but it would be nice to get one or two iconic ships in the collection. Snowspeed is definitely one of them. And definitely Slave 1 and a X-Wing. If they ever did a Y-Wing, that's another favourite ship of mine as well. I would like to get that. This is too much Star Wars. I'm a massive Star Wars fan. I love it all. So this is the speeder bike for the moment. So I'm hoping to get myself another speeder bike at some point. But hopefully soon I will see some more vehicles coming my way. I've got myself Luke's Land Speeder and I got Ray's Speeder as well. I'll be doing reviews of those as well. I might even do a bit of a comparison between all three. But at the moment though, this is the daddy. This is the real daddy. This is the one that I need in my collection. So anyway, this is Toy Therapy signing off. Until next time, thank you very much for watching. Please give me a like, share, subscribe. I do know I'm doing old figures. People have already seen them. Like I said, I'm not doing it for views. I'm not doing it for likes. I'm just doing it because I got a backlog of figures I got to get through. And I thought, what the hell? Just get them done, because I am putting them all on display. So I'm going through all of them in turn. So thank you very much for watching. You've been awesome. And remember, if you can give me a like and subscribe, that would be fantastic. See you guys and girls next time. Bye-bye.